In the 48 races held at Spa between 1950 and 2015, the race winner has only started from pole position on 16 occasions. Qualifying yesterday may have set the order for today, but expect the unexpected here at the Belgian Grand Prix. As the saying goes, of course, anything can happen. And you know what? It usually does. So here we are once again at Spa-Francorchamps, with 19 corners, 9 to the right and 10 to the left, and a lap distance of 4.35 miles. An average lap speed in the dry here is around 145 miles per hour. It's a very quick circuit indeed. A warm welcome to Anthony Davidson, who's beside me in the commentary box today. Let's talk about Red. There's been some controversy surrounding some comments they made in the media recently. What's your take on that?
I think the fans always find it refreshing to find a driver who speaks their mind, but it's generally not a great idea to go around bad-mouthing the people who employ you and build your car. These are the people you want to keep motivated and on your side.
We're almost ready to go then, and this is what the starting grid looks like for today's race. Red lines up on pole position, and starting alongside in P2 is Sebastian Vettel. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Bottas, Ricciardo, Max Verstappen, and Perez, Ocon, Leclerc, Sainz, and Nico Hülkenberg, Ericsson, Magnussen, Lewis Hamilton, and Van Dorn, Alonso, Grosjean, Lance Stroll, and Pierre Gasly. Hartley and Sergei Sirotkin rounds off the grid. And now it's time to head down to the track.
Okay, La Source is always pretty tight, but we've got a clear run. Remember the runoff if you need it. Start. We're going to want to put some temperature into the tyres and brakes to keep the engine cooler so don't go too high with the revs. Start sequence will begin as soon as the grid has formed. Be ready with the clutch.
Thank you.
Fantastic. You've won the Grand Prix.
A great win then for the Maranello team today. So Ant, how exactly did they set themselves apart from the pack today?
Rain always has the potential to liven up a race and mix up the order, and they've taken full advantage of that to claim the victory today. It's always a bit of a lottery when the conditions are like this, but they've managed to stay on circuit and have come out on top.
So, here they come now, out onto the podium. Wherever you go, anywhere in the world, the Prancing Horse flags are dominant in the grandstands, and they're out in force again today. It's Ferrari, on the top step once more. And now let's take a look at the driver's standings. Red increases their championship lead. Now then, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Fernando Alonso. Wherever he is, whatever team he's in, when is he not just brilliant? He'll give you a performance every time, just like he's done today.
And now let's take a look at the constructors' standings. Ferrari moved to the top of the table. There was also a strong showing from the McLaren team today as they make their way up the standings. There'll be plenty more twists and turns to come this season. I hope you can join us at the next race to see just who will come out on top.